Haagen-Dazs was founded in 1961. Ruben and Rose Mattis were the couple that founded the brand. Ruben actually was the catalyst to start the company. His mother had an Italian ice business where she sold ice pops and confections out of literally a horse-drawn carriage. They started to manufacture ice cream, and Ruben wanted to do something that was a little more high quality than the product that his mother was manufacturing. So he came up with the formula for Haagen-Dazs. According to Rose, Ruben wanted to have a name that had another world quality or an idea or a feeling of it that it came from somewhere else. And so he was very enamored with Dutch, Swedish modern architecture and furniture and things like that. And he came up with the name Haagen-Dazs, which was his playing around with the words Duncan Hines, which he actually thought was a very high quality product at the time. And he came up with Haagen-Dazs. The name means absolutely nothing. In fact, the umlauts do not even exist in that language. The original shop is on Montague Street in Brooklyn. It was opened by Ruben's daughter in 1976. Ruben didn't want a franchise. In fact, he didn't want to have shops at all. In 1973, they achieved countrywide distribution, so they were finally able to get the ice cream everywhere. And his daughter Doris saw it as an opportunity with shops to get another point of distribution for the products. Within 2 or 3 years, we had 50 or 60 franchise agreements signed all across the country. And when he sold to Pillsbury, the funny part was at that point, he was adamant that they had to keep franchising. The original flavors, curiously enough, were vanilla, chocolate, and coffee. It actually took Ruben 6 years to come up with a strawberry that had the high quality that he wanted in all of his products. The ice cream is made pretty specifically. We only have one plant in the entire country that makes Haagen-Dazs bulk, which is what goes into the tubs for shops. That's in California. We don't co-pack it. There's no one else who's allowed to manufacture the ice cream. We use all natural ingredients, so everything that's in our ice cream is all natural. It's why our mint isn't green, why our pistachio isn't green, and Haagen-Dazs has a much less amount of air than the average ice cream, which is why it's called super premium. The other thing it has is a higher amount of butter fat. So butter fat is what gives you that mouthfeel and that texture in ice cream, also adds calories and fat. But you put those two things together and that's how what makes us a super premium ice cream. One of the things that Ruben was adamant about was sampling. And so one of his strategies was to go in and get it in people's mouths. So he would actually literally go into a deli, take a couple pints, and sample it to people who were walking in the door. We continue to do that in shops for the very same reason, because we know that once you get the ice cream in somebody's mouth, that they're smitten, and it's very difficult to say no. So what Ruben did in the beginning to overcome his struggle has now become a real standard business practice for us.
That's good. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.